Today, we're going to be installing one of the best fuel systems you can get for your 300ZX. And as far as I know, the only available upgrade on the market for your fuel pump hanger. If you aren't familiar with polar engineering by now, you should be, and hopefully by the end of this video, you will be. Because today we're going to be installing this bad boy right here, which is the polar engineering billet fuel pump hanger for the 2+0 model. Now, polar engineering will also offer fuel pump installs when you purchase the hanger. For me, I got two 45 Walbro fuel pumps already bolted in, mounted, ready to go with new fuel pump socks, which are a must for any new fuel pump you're gonna run in the car. This is gonna be a nice upgrade. We'll be able to flow all the fuel we'll ever need probably for this car. The main limiting factor here is going to be the two Walbro 485s. I could upgrade these to a Walbro 525 Hellcat fuel pump in the future if I need to, but for now, I think this is what we're gonna work with and this should be plenty. So let me just go over this fuel pump and why this is a much better option than anything else you could potentially get. Outside of the fact that it is obviously billet, it has countersunk screws all the way around it that mount in the factory position. There are options for dash 6, dash 8, or even the factory fuel line to be wired in or plumbed into here rather. Over here you have the vent tube, and then you have your wiring connector. So we got our power and grounds for the Walbro fuel pumps, and then we also have our factory sensor and connectors here for the fuel system level and fuel pump control module connectors. So there's just some extra bits, and it's nice to have the new wiring. The factory wiring is known to heat up and burn out as you put more current through them. And so I ordered this fuel pump with the Walbro 485s already in the fuel pump, and he did everything, got it all set up and ready to go for me. So all I have to do is literally pull the old one out, drop this one in, which is another cool thing if you order the fuel pumps with it. If you can, highly suggest doing it. That way you don't have to worry about troubleshooting anything else. You got all new fuel pumps, so on and so forth. Now with my setup, I have it wired to a Haltech. So with the Haltech, I can have one pump running full time and the other one is set to turn on as soon as I get into boost. As you can see, I've already got the top hat off, all this stuff off. So I've already ran one dash 8 line through here. I just wanted to see if it would fit. It's not that simple, but it does fit. Now there are three little hard lines here that are physically impossible to remove without dropping the fuel tank, which the fuel tank in the 2+0 is a saddle tank. To get this fuel tank out, I believe I would need to drop the subframe, which I'm not doing. If memory serves me correct, this is a Radium Engineering connector that I rewired my factory fuel pump wiring. That's what all this is up here. So I may have to redo some of that, or at least redo this connector. We'll see what happens when that time comes. But for right now, we're gonna work on getting this out of here. Okay guys, so this is my factory-ish fuel pump setup. As you can see, it was not fun getting out of there and it actually ripped off a hose just pulling it out. Yeah, this is pretty much my setup. I used hose clamps to hold the two 485 fuel pumps together. And then we did a Summit Racing Y connector in the regular fuel line. I didn't want to use accordion hose. A lot of people like to use accordion hose, but the new fuel pump setup does have accordion hose meant for ethanol and the right fuel lines and all that stuff, ready to go. Don't do this. This is certainly cheaper, don't get me wrong. So I did this pretty much entire setup for less than 300 bucks. For the extra $100, just get the polar engineering kit, because this is not worth it. Trust me when I say that. So once again, side by side comparison here. This is the factory setup that I rigged together. I made work with two fuel pumps. It is giant, it's bulky. The fuel pump level sender will get caught on random stuff. It's a pain in the ass to get in and out. And then you have the polar engineering. I mean, just look at the quality of this stuff. It's seamless, it's simple, it's nice and straight and compact. Everything's neatly tucked together. Like, you don't have to go through this Don't do this to yourself. Take my word for it. It's not worth it. And then you have these stupid fittings on top that you gotta fight with, not to mention the electrical connector. I spent a lot of time researching for the right electrical connector for this, and that was the most I could come up with. Just a little side note to add, this hole is not originally here. I cut this out when I first did my fuel pump setup. I needed access one way or another, and that was the only way I had to get such access. Sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. Okay, so a little suggestion with installing one of these, if you haven't done it for the first time, take your time with installing the bolts and tightening them down. If you don't, you will strip one out. It's very easy to do. Do not use an electric tool, use a hand tool. Okay, so we're back at it today. I've had to put the electric power steering pump conversion on hold right now. So that means this video is gonna be coming out before that video. We're gonna be finishing up the fuel pump install. The fuel pump hanger itself is in. I just have to run another dash 8 feed line to the rear. The fuel system will then be set and ready to go in this car. Now, this fuel system should be capable of easily doing 1,000 horsepower on E85. It will be completely dash 8 from the fuel pump hanger back. And then we have two Walbro 485s in tank already. I do have a fuel filter that I will be installing. I was gonna install it in the front of the car, but I think I'm gonna install it actually in the rear. This is the fuel filter that I will be installing. I actually bought this a while back. It's actually capable of running anywhere from dash 6 to dash 12 AN fittings. We will only be running dash 8 obviously to match what's down there. So I'll just mount this up underneath the car, throw some fittings on it, and that should be pretty straightforward. Okay, before I get started on installing the new hose, I want to show you guys exactly what I had in here before. Now these here are hardline to AN hose adapter fittings. When you order these, I made this mistake initially. Make sure you get the correct adapter fittings that'll match the steel that you are using. Now you can get these for either copper, aluminum, or steel. Make sure you get the ones that are meant for steel, or else it will leak. Now all I did was use a pipe cutter, cut the factory hard line, and then slide this on over top, crimp it down as it tightened down. Now if you guys aren't familiar with how AN hoses work, the numbers actually represent something. They're not just generic numbers. So you could say the equivalent to a dash 6 AN line is the equivalent to a 6/16 line, which is roughly 3/8, or dash 8 AN is the equivalent of 8/16, which is half inch, and so on. And that's pretty much how AN fittings work. So for electrical, if you guys remember, I had my old factory fuel pump setup was kind of already modified. So what I'm dealing with here are not factory wires. So what I'm going to do is chop these wires to get rid of this connector over here, and I'm going to basically just splice it into these. Now when I do my electrical wiring, I only like to use butt connectors and heat shrink. It is actually advised by a lot of professionals in the industry that you don't use solder on motorsport wiring. And the reason for that is because over time, while solder may seem like a more permanent fix, over time the solder is actually prone to cracking and breaking, which could create a weakened point in the harness. Whereas with the butt connector, if you crimp it properly, you should never have to worry about it again, especially with some good insulated heat shrink that goes on over top of that. I have decided, I dimpled this down. Basically, I took a pry bar and a hammer to that, so it angles down, so it won't be cutting into the wiring here. So, this is kind of what I'm thinking for a fuel filter. Somewhere in this area. I think y'all get the idea if I do something like that. And then, yeah, I think that'll work out really nicely. I have an idea. This is gonna work out really well. Okay, so in case you guys were wondering what the fuel filter bracket I made looks like overall in general, this is pretty much it. It's literally just self-tapped in. I made the small section, or the center section smaller, so that these would wrap around in a more circular motion instead of being so square. And then I just have four self-tappers holding it in, and that thing is in there tight. It's not going anywhere. Famous last words, right? So then we just slide the fuel filter in like this. Then we just tighten down the hose clamps. Let's carry on with these fuel fittings for this fuel filter and go from there. Late, but I'm gonna go ahead and show you the quick rundown of everything after the fuel pump on up to the front of the car. Starting with the fuel filter, we got the bracket held on with two hose clamps. We got dash 8 to a 90 to a 90 coming out. And then these lines here are for my power steering, which I'll show you in the next video. Unfortunately, I don't have that ready yet. I'm waiting on yet another electronic power steering pump. Aside from that, fuel lines, we go through here. So this is a setup that I've made. Now you can buy something similar to this online, but it's much more compact when you buy it online, but I went ahead and purchased this one. Basically what I did was I bypassed my flex fuel sensor, so I'm not restricted down to a -6 to a 3/8 inch line for the flex fuel sensor. So it actually splits here into a dual feed -6 and then back to a -8 up here. Which I need more light. There you go. That should give you a better idea. Now, these are just ongoing for now. I don't have them terminated up front because I don't have the motor in it. I'll worry about that once the motor gets here. All right, you guys, I guess it's gonna do that for this video today. I hope you at least learned something. If anything, it gives you an idea if you ever wanna upgrade your fuel system for your 300ZX. By next week, I should have the video out for the electric power steering pump. If you guys haven't already, make sure you're subscribed so you get the notifications of when I post the next video, because I assure you, you don't wanna miss what's coming up. We are doing some game-changing stuff for this car, and this motor in general. As you can see, if you aren't familiar already, I hope you all learned something. Take care. We'll see you next time.